Hello!
Welcome.
It's Mavanjo.
How are we doing?
Now, when we initially found that there was a new brewery in Yorkshire, there was 4 beers released from this brewery. Mm. Andrew went out and purchased all 4 beers.
From Beer House itself.
Yeah, I mean, Beer House.
He had them all 4 of them.
But then... David, not David Allen, Kevin Black got one of these beers sent to him.
Mm.
And Andrew went, wait a minute, Andrew's there. See this beer anywhere.
Yeah.
It is the Battied Hefeweizen.
The thing is with this beer is that we was only able to get it from Halifax. Was it the... I'm trying to remember the shop now. Is it the it used to be the Owls?
Beer Wine Direct.
That's the one, yeah. And I've only seen it there.
But now it's available at Trembling Manors and all the other beer shops.
Mm.
Just show you the tag while Andrew opens the bottle.
Oh shit.
Oh shit. Balls.
Exploded.
Did it?
Bingo.
This beer will explode if Andrew opens it to us. I'm only joking.
Oh man, that is smell.
Get a tissue. Andrew over exploded everywhere.
I'm excited about this beer.
It's not the first time it's exploded or something.
Yeah. But
banana, cloves.
As soon as I open it, though, you're definitely getting the Belgium style with the cloves and the coriander.
Definitely get the Belgian yeast as well.
Oh, it's lovely. It smells like a wheat beer, you know what I mean?
Mm.
Or wheat beer. Or...
It almost smells like a Belgian ale, though. Belgian ale.
Yeah, Bavarian style wheat beer in a real bad seed. It was one of the first beers to beat the Rheinalsteiger bottle.
I'll show the bottle in a minute.
The strict German purity laws rules about the beer are still really loved the dish.
Yeah, I mean, in England and Europe, they do make strong on the laws of brewing beer. Little America, they're a bit more freelance.
Smells lovely though. It's like sweet, fragrant, subtle, and very, very relaxed on the taste. Very.
It reminds me a lot of the Colonel Beers, the Bad Seed.
Oh, with the wrapper thing.
Yeah.
Because they used to. Colonel puts the brown wrapper on it, don't they?
Mm.
But
a lot of brown sugar on the smell.
Thing with Bad Seed is that they change the colour so that you don't get mixed up.
It
smells like
black pepper,
coconut, banana, and sugar. Only slight coconut though.
Oh, that's that. I've got a coconut porter at Spano.
Huh?
Dexter, I've got a coconut porter at Spano.
Coconut porter? But, you definitely get sort of, almost like...
Almonds.
Yeah.
A little bit of almonds and a little bit of clove and banana.
Mm.
Andrew drew a bottle test. Yeah.
Mm.
Clove, banana, easy. It's a nice, easy drinking beer. Mm.
Very nice. I'd definitely buy this again. It's really nice.
You know what I had when I was drinking that? Now, I don't know if it's because Andrew likes Home and Away and Neighbours, but when I was drinking it, I just picked to myself, drinking this, going out surfing, coming back. Oh no, drink it now and picture yourself going out surfing, Come back. It's a small bottle. You know what I mean?
You sort of have that clarity of it there, where it's just it's not super tasting of anything.
No.
It's sort of nice and subtle taste.
Yeah.
And you can enjoy the beer, you know what I mean, rather than find the beer.
I mean, if you've been out surfing or whatever,
that'd be a nice beer to go with.
Yeah. Nice pairing. Risking your life in front of sharks.
What?
This is a nice taste beer.
Yeah.
And it's a mark of what an Effervescing does.
Mm.
See this? Buy this. Bad seed.
Could have gone wrong. Effervescing. Not bad seed.
I think these two have been the favourite ones of all their range.
I mean, the others have been nice.
Yeah.
But not, like, out there.
Yeah.
And this one's got, like, the bad seed espresso stout. It's, like, been... You know what I mean?
Get that. We love the espresso stout because it's our favourite style of stout, and we love the Effervescing because it reminds us of the first style of beer that we started drinking.
I mean, what people sometimes like is, like, they look for a lot of it in beers is coffee in the stouts, and we found coffee in that, and for this one, we've got that German feel. A lot of people relate beer to Germans. You know
yeah,
what
I mean?
They're the first ones to brew beer.
Yeah. I mean, when we first started drinking beer, we tried all the commercial stuff. But the fact is, we loved more the European-style beers initially, didn't we?
I think it was more of the category of German and Czech Republic, because they're the start of all beers.
Yeah, I mean...
Because they're the oldest.
Yeah, I mean, still now. I mean, when we go to Blanger in Bradford, it's like, anytime we see something we instantly have, don't we?
Yeah, that's it. It's
we love our European beers, and this nails that European beer feel.
Oh, yeah.
You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.